Good morning, it's Saturday, the 27th of June, and we have rushed up here to the south deck, down here rather, in the interest of capturing the Saturday morning special KAL Cargo 747. Let's hope for some engine fog. We have interesting conditions this morning. Lover cast with sun breaks, and look at that. What a great way to start the morning off. This is traveling to Seattle, and I don't think I can recall what its flight number was. Oh, there we go, wing shimmer. Yes, the wing shimmer definitely erased whatever the flight number is from my brain. Maybe 865. By the way, as soon as we get this, we leave the south deck and go sky meadow. Enough of capturing our side-stick monster machine. Boy, my tripod is not set up right there. I have a little fumbly. Don't mind my fumbly. Don't know the flight number, but I do know it originated in Jacksonville, Florida. We're enjoying the sky meadow in spite of very tall grass here, as is typical for the summertime. Oh goodness, yeah, look at that. Oh, glow vapor too. Goodness. It's a very good show for a door check failure. Nice. So on the docket for today, we have morning vapor. We'll have some heating. Ow, like that sun coming out and heating my face. It's blinding me. And then, hopefully, some violent skies, as thunderstorms are forecast for the afternoon. Some may be locally heavy, strong, or severe. Let us all pray for the severe. I think these events will probably begin after the lunch hour, current local time, 9:25. So battery management will also be on the docket for the day. Let's watch this vapor producer overhead as he returns from Jacksonville without winglets. Oh my! These mad dogs are putting on one hell of a vapor show as they burst forth from the lover cast. It is very, very humid out here already, and a stiff breeze to boot. Out of the west, primarily. Maybe a little bit southwest. But look at that, God! Ordinarily, I ignore these mad dogs because they are a dime a dozen. But when they're producing vapor of this magnitude, it's pretty hard to ignore. Still got some nice vape coming off the right wing there. Oh yes, the glow. See, I love glow vapor. Whenever the sunshine comes out and illuminates the vapor, turns it into glow vapor, just in case you didn't know the definition. Most of you are smart enough to figure that out, though. Oh, see? Look at that. It's starting to dissipate. Oh, that's sad. He's got a little bit more left, I'm sure, for the overhead. Mad dog. Mad dog. Coming home to Hartsfield, Maynard, Jackson, Airport, Maynard, Holbrook, Jackson, Atlanta, Maynard, Maynard, Mad Dog comes on home to roost today. Very good. 88. Very sharp. You were very sharp today, sir. Any minute now. There. Yes. Oh, gorgeous. Look at all the vape. Sweet! Oh, I definitely made a good decision in coming to Sky Meadow for Side Stick Monster Machine Saturday morn. Oh, my. Oh, beautiful. Now, the vapor is one thing that the computers on board the machine cannot control. It is nature, Mother Nature, that controls that. Looks like he's making a little bit of course deviation here. Oh boy, oh my God. Wait, where's he going? Whoa, whoa, are you sidestepping? You son of a bitch! You are a son of a bitch side stick monster machine! I'm gonna have to get up. What is he doing? Is this a sidestep? He's off course, for sure. Oh, you stupid sidestep monster! Now I have to stand up. No wonder I didn't hear his clearance. He was cleared on the other frequency. Ah, crapazoid. Well, now we're gonna be walking around here, trying to catch this, so I'll try to keep him in box while I continue my bipedal movement here. Let's stop for a second. He's gonna go behind the sky for us, then we're gonna run up to the top of a hill. Sidestick monster machine sidesteps! Spoiling my Sunday sidestick monster machine overhead! But we'll run, run, run! And try our best to catch it now. Whoa! Cool! Very good. I'm kind of disappointed in you, though. That was a real mean thing to do to a guy. It's okay. The machine doesn't know what feelings are, so it doesn't understand the concept of hurting one's feelings. Alright, well, this is a little bit late on my part. I should have caught up with this king by now, but I have not. Service to Honolulu has been going on for a few weeks now. I have not seen it yet. It looks glorious, just like the king always does. I'm wondering if there's going to be any engine fog. Oh, yes, Your Majesty. Salute you and worship. Quite blustery out here, be careful, King. Early rotation. Wow, look at that. Sunburst tree. Oh, beautiful. Smoky and glorious. Now these are cloud tops right here. That represents about 20,000 feet. You can see those starting to pop up. Those are basically cumulus boils. And that's how we spot them on our new fancy radar. And this looks like one that's topping out pretty high. It is still before the noon hour. Thunderstorms are not supposed to arrive until 2 or 3 o'clock, according to the Weather Channel hourly forecast, which is always full of shit. Feels like 86 degrees. Let's see if we can't get it to where you can see that. 2.71, that's a high dew point. 2.992, low pressure. And now our hourly. Where is our hourly? Get all this crap out of the way. So, oh, they're pushing it back. They say zero. Well, this can't be right at all. More. Oh, five, we're pushing it. Oh, and six is 85%, okay. So we see what the Weather Channel predicts. I say it's gonna be sooner than that. Will it be? Stay tuned and find out next. Well, kick me in the Jimmy and call me Susan. Here comes Dynasty, coming into OTP. Outside the perimeter or runway 28, because there's some kind of unconventional bias against runway 27 left today. I pray Cathay Pacific 91 Heavy, who is immediately in trail of Dynasty, does not go down Dynasty's nasty way. It's a real shame. It's a crying shame. I mean, without Super Zoom, we would just have to sit here and cry. Literally. Because we wouldn't be able to do this. We gotta have the Super Zoom. We can see it with the Super Zoom. It's not always pretty and it's hard to maintain. See, I just botched it again. This is why we don't like it when they land on runway 28. Damn it. Looking in the distance for Cathay Pacific, not seeing it. Let's get back onto the Free Chinese. I don't even think this is worthy of singing Free Chinese, to be honest with you. So we won't. If I catch this one on the course, I'll sing it. Right now, this is not really Free Chinese at all. It's just kind of like smelling the delicious smell of Free Chinese, but not actually getting to taste it. That's what we're dealing with here with these outside the perimeter situations. Thanks a lot, Dynasty. Where the hell? Oh, God. Oh, God. No. Yep. As we thought. It looks like Cathay Pacific. is following in Dynasty's treacherous trail. But let's not be too downtrodden. He does have next generation or Generation X engines. It's Generation X, just like I am. I am Gen X. The last cool generation. All the younger ones are morons. Just kidding. It's giving you a hard time. I like to give millennials a hard time. Okay, enough about millennials and my superior Generation X. Let's watch this 748 land on runway 28. Quiet disgust. It's fighting off some wind. That's impressive. Very good. Now the ground is within my box, and we can finally put this whole sordid affair out of our minds and move on to bigger and better things. Wow, that's like a skyrocketing mad dog. I'm sorry, that startled me. It's just a skyrocket. It's going straight up. Good job, mad dog. Good job. And kudos, Cathay Pacific, for looking so sharp. Oh, yeah, Dynasty, too. Kudos to you for doing what's convenient for you and your cargo needs, not me and my plane spot needs. Jesus. This is the consolation prize we get for missing two jumbo jets on runway 28. We get a 767 parade kickoff. Wow, isn't that ducky? So ducky, I shake the box inadvertently. Oh, that's kind of nice. I mean, it's a heavy. We'll try to appreciate it. We're going to have to get on some battery charging if we hope to survive until storms get here, if the Weather Channel hourly app is correct. But I don't believe it is. Either way, battery management is always wise, and we do need to report to the Diplomats Club for that, as well as some other responsibilities that I have today. What are those responsibilities? Stay tuned and find out next. Okay, we have incoming that is to our south, and it is producing. And what did I tell you about the Weather Channel hourly app? I'm better than it. Let's see, I bet you it's updated now. I bet you anything, Weather Channel hourly is gonna say something totally different. You can see I'm better than the hourly app. Let's see. Who's going to win this one? Oh, I'm going to win. Still. Definitely. You say zero, I say a lot more than that. And I'm kind of humiliated to be doing radar for real life reconciliation, considering the last time I did this, I left my cell phone on the top of my car, and it cost me $500 to replace. So this is really going to start affecting these departures. And we have KAL Sidestick Monster Machine, the one who sidestepped us this morning. I wonder if we'll get a thunderstorm coming here and rain on old Sidestick Monster Machine's parade. It's a computer, it doesn't know how to deal with nature and thunderstorms and whatnot. It'll be hilarious. You can see the top right here. This thing is getting bigger. These guys are making more aggressive maneuvers to get out of its way. And now we have boilers right here. This is actually brewing. Not producing any kind of precipitation or any kind of bang for your buck, but I think that it's probably gonna create something for us here shortly. This could blow up very easily as well. We are right on the precipice. Sidestick Monster Machine, ready to go, ready to face Mother Nature. Oh, this is going to be a sight. The wind is picking up here. Shutdowns. Oh, ho, ho, ho! Thunder! Oh, beautiful. Absolutely, positively, the best simultaneous occurrence I could have imagined. Okay, let's focus on the Sidestick Monster Machine and nothing else. Can the computers save you today? Will they? Or will you just become another one of the rabble victims struck by lightning and made a fool of by Mother Nature? Oh, baby. Here he goes, rotation. I wouldn't be surprised if I started getting some raindrops here in about 2 seconds. Holy shit. Oh, Gatorade bottle, look out. Oh, my. Oh, beautiful. Here comes the money shot. What are you gonna do, Mr. Man Pie? What are you gonna do? Holy shitfire, I love it! Oh, Boise's. I guess Korean Airlines can't give you a very good pie rep since he can't speak the best of English. Just gonna go straight, guy. Oh, I see. Yeah, you would bank right anyway. Oh, this is going to be sweet. Look at this. Holy shit fire. It's gonna look beautiful. See the rain core and the what looks to be severe. I bet you ain't severe quite yet, but it will be. Oh, yeah. Oh, sweet. Besides, big monster machine appears to be making it safely out of Hartlanta. Hartlanta's being a little feisty today, isn't it? Okay, who's cleared? Oh, that looks like a heavy. I just haven't been paying attention. Oh, snap! Oh, the rain is coming down now. Oh boy, we're gonna have to get in the car as soon as this is over. But wowzers, look at this! Delta 95 in a head-to-head grudge match against Mother Nature. Holy shit! And the thunder rolls as the rain gets harder and harder, and this is when my camera begins screaming in pain, but you can't hear it. Can't hear it screaming. We just know it is. Ooh, boy. Oh, man alive. I'm just gonna take the lens flatter and take it. Ah, yeah! Hell yeah! Delta 95 heavy! Oh, fuck yes, baby! Oh, man! Brilliant! Look at it go! Look at it go! Oh, yeah! Current local time, 1 o'clock, according to this analog clock that is, for some reason, placed in the landscaping of Hartsfield, Maynard, Holdrup, Jackson, International Atlanta. My speed? Sweet! I get to gauge my own speed? Let's go! Yeah! Oh, damn it, I got up to 7 real quick there. Did you see that? Is he even going? Can't tell if that guy's actually moving or not. He is, but he's moving very slowly. Are you moving? Whoa, there was lightning right there. Maybe the next to the tri-hole. Damn, dude, you can never take off at this speed. Okay, yeah, this is not a takeoff. This is a taxi. God, look at that rain coming down right there. Crazy. Crazy rain core right there. Kind of isolated. I bet you that's going to expand into something even more magnificent. It's blowing in from the west, so I'll hang out over here. Lens flatter is not necessarily going to affect me. My poor secondary camera might be getting slapped right now. We better check on him. Wow. Ew. It's like being injected with, no, really, not heroin. Whoa! Heroin doesn't make you all excited and giddy. You just like pass out. I don't know, what do I know? Sporadic lightning. Whoa, there, speaking of the devil, it's the lightning itself. Oh, I love it all so very much. Hey, looks like a mad dog's coming out to play in it. Good for you, guy. Good for you. Pretty much zero visibility out here. Can't see a damn thing. And just for fun, let's see what the Weather Channel hourly app says now. Oh, how you changed your tune since about an hour ago. Oh, boysies. You're giving me a break at 4 o'clock? That's your theory? Let's get some more. Oh, 38, yeah. I see what you're saying, but let's see if it comes true. What the hell? What do I hear? Is that a go-around or a takeoff? I can't see it. Oh, it's a go-round. It must be. I just barely saw its shadow. It looked like a southwester. Here we have regained our visibility, at least to some degree. End of storm over here, it looks like. I don't know. I haven't even had time to look at my pocket radar. Oh, boy, he says lightning.
And a runway 26 right departure, wind shear alert. The 2-mile departure are indicating a 20-knot loss.
Did you hear that, Reginald? You're too young for this. Way too young. The line is beginning to stack up here. None but mad dogs. Runway lights look spectacular. I know I need to go to the diplomats club, but I'm just mesmerized by all the sights and sounds here. Which you would be too if you were.
Right,
like
Tower 8-4908. We're sitting here looking at it, and it looks like the departure corridor actually looks okay. We're about to have to make a right turn just past impasse for weather out there, but initially it looks okay towards impasse.
Really?
Sure. 4908, Roger. I had a wind chill alert in America. It's just subsided. So what you're telling me is you end up having to make a right turn after departure?
Yeah, once the wind shear clears, we'd end up right turn along the
Right now, 8-4908, Roger. I'm no longer indicating that wind shear, and it's been released, so 8-4908, fly heading 300.
No shit. You getting clearance?
Clear to take off.
Wow! Look at you, AC. Talking ATC into letting you go. My goodies. Not even the Tri-Hold pilots managed to do that. All right, let's see you in this hole that you talked about. Actually, maybe we should walk over here to this hole. So we can see if we see it first too. Yeah, I can kind of see that. Okay, I see what he's talking about. Now, Reginald, let's see if you have the skills.
Flagship for the air 3447, start them up. 8623, I'll start them up too.
I guess everybody's ready to go now.
We'll let this Pathfinder get out there a little ways and see what he reports back to us.
Okay. Alright, Reginald, this is your moment to establish credibility. If you get struck by lightning, no one will ever believe you again. And we'll just go ahead and head this way. Watch, Reginald. A little bit of splatter here.
Hey, Mike. 8669, you're entering a heavy zone. 78 looks like about 1 mile long, directly off the final.
Yes, sir. Right now, we have moderate rain and end of it, Mike.
Roger. I'm going to get a ride report and then,
Oh, nice.
We'll end up getting out of here. You can hear there's more holes on the hip drive. Okay.
Wow. Actually, it's not even raining. I don't even need to be subterranean anymore. I forgot about that. Oh, look who's here. A Reginald also ushering in the first arrivals in a long time. Damn it. I kind of want to see the Falcon go, but I need to go get food and get the diplomats to charge my batteries.
Are you about ready?
You and your nose-down attitude.
I feel smug.
Whoa! Well, I'll just drop the $400 phone. I'm at the seat. I'm sure it's fine. Yeah, I blame you, Reg. Oh, Jesus, I'm getting text messages. You know what I feel about those. Oh, Ben and Bobby. Jesus Christ. You both know better than this. Okay, Ben, I just gave you a why. I answered your text message with why. Yes, if I was at the airport. Perhaps he saw my Instagram post. Radar through life reconciliation. Maybe I should stop doing that when I'm out here. Get less text messages that way. That's right, Ben. And Bobby. Oh, Bobby's going to JFK tomorrow. Look at that. That's a nice little text message from old Bobby. I'll catch up with him later. I'm too busy. I'll answer his questions. We're in the mid for some thrust reverser spray by this beautiful arriver. Son of a slut. That's probably Ben. Ben is about to get a nasty text. Just says, dude, I can't conversate while I'm in the middle of doing this. I have two cameras. I have a tendency to drop and break phones. Oh, I missed the thrust reverser spray. You kidding me? Come on, tool shed. Don't take it away. Damn. So there's some brand new, I guess, surplus parking spots here that these 767 parade members are occupying. Both private first class. And as we continue, that's the Rennie right there. I totally forgot about the Rennie. Sorry. I know you all wanted to see that, but I figured the airplanes might be more important. Whoa, that's a cool one. Whoa, cool lightning back there too. Oh, boy. Coming in on everyone's favorite runway today, are we? Is this Virgin? It would have to be. It would have to be, and yes, it is. Coming in on runway 28 for some reason. preferred runway today. It is raining. It is definitely umbrella-worthy. I just have been too lazy to go grab it. So as a result, we're getting lens flare. And the Sony Cybershot grows a little bit closer to death because I'm sure it can't take much more of this abuse. Well, that was a good pie wrap, and we were fogged out because I was wiping this thing clean of the lens flatter a few moments ago. We are capturing a virgin. I don't know which one. We're just glad that he didn't have to divert with all the holding that I bet she's going on right now. And these Euro originators are going to have a hard time, but in other news, to our west, it looks like cleary skies with lens flatter. My, my, my. Stepping out of the car now, the precipitation has passed, only to find yet another celebrity of Hartsfield is picking runway 28. Look at this, Sky Team 764. My goodness, what is wrong with you? Why is that the preferred runway today? Oh well, I guess we have bigger things to worry about, like these cumulus boils, or that cumulus boil. Or maybe that contrailer up there, huh? All the weather seems to be moving off to the east now. Getting even sweeter things are, as now a virgin dares to come a little closer. Just a little closer, come closer, virgin. Virgins are so timid. I could explain the first virgin's arrival on runway 28. This one's a little bit more bold. More bold. So we are thanking the Lord above. Precipitation isn't falling from the sky. There are still storms popping to my south, but for the most part I'm in the clear. But more will brew to the west, as it will likely get sunny here shortly, making it even more humid and creating an environment which is conducive for more severe thunderstorms. And actually, the ones from this morning weren't severe at all. There was no severe weather warnings attached to that. What's up, man? That's my buddy John. I don't think he recognized me. So we lost to France a lot as the storms to the east move farther to the east, giving these guys some breathing room when it comes to their downwinds, base turns, and final approaches. Okay, let's keep the not-so-Monty Frog in the box and in focus, shall we? I'm just looking around at other things. This battery is now beginning to cause issues. Oh Jesus, battery crisis. And if this is just round one, I'm in troubles. Very nice. Was lightning back there? Oh, sweet, what is this? Oh, very radical. I love that old school straight tail. Neato mosquito, listen. Cool. Oh, this is really sweet. I love it. What is that? I don't know what that is. Looks like a 1950s Seneca or something, yeah? It's a Piper model or something like that. Maybe an Aztec. Old school. Oh boy. Off into the western sky where you can see here the boils that exist. Let's get back to this old school one. I liked him. Let's see if he's gonna do a bank. I mean, you'd think he would do a courtesy bank, you know, for all the big jets, but there's not really any big jets taking off right now, so I guess I can really be leisurely about it. And he's being leisurely, so we're just looking at cloud tops here. This is all the stuff that has passed me already. But this right here, right on the Georgia-Alabama border where the fireworks are on sale, is this. It's topping out here at 30, 40,000 feet. So really, that is like over on the Georgia-Alabama border. This right here is topping out pretty good. Let me see him. What is your altitude, young man? Oh, surprise, surprise, surprise. Lufty has chosen all the popular kids and is also going on runway 28. Well, boo for you. Boo for you. Lufthansa. You guys just want to have a long taxi today. I don't know why. I mean, I can understand it if you are a cargo carrier, because it's right next to your ramp, you know, especially if you're free Chinese or Hong Kongian. But, you know, your passengers have already been on board for a long time. It's a very underpowered A340, so they are all exhausted, just like your airplane is. Why are you going to put it through more of its paces when you could simply arrive on runway 27 left, hang a right, and go straight to your parking spot, and then you can go to the hotel and be sexy Germans, you know? Well, who knows what's gonna happen next. All I know is I need some more charge. And Lufthansa is so, so far away amongst the foreign entanglements. Will disappear among the sea of other SUVs and stupid vehicles that are out here because this place is packed. Oh, interrupting a charging session while I charge one battery using my automobile and the other using an outlet. Colorado statehood livery passes me by. I jump out of the car to grab it. That's a big C. It stands for Colorado. Oh yes, into the myriad of SUVs, church buses, and other passenger automobiles, this Colorado-clad Southwester comes on in to runway 26 right. In other news, the additional responsibility we had here at Diplomats Club is wasp extermination. Not a massive assault or bombardment, merely the killing of some wasp, and just so happens there's a brand new nest here on the central easternmost Cinco. So we will fulfill that obligation before leaving, but we need our batteries primed for the severe weather expected later this afternoon. This is called planning ahead and doing the work now so we can have fun later instead of having the fun now and having to like work hard later to try to charge batteries and whatnot. I don't know if that analogy really fit. It's really humid out here, so my brain's kind of wandering. Not really talking any sense or anything. You know, stumbling over words, watching Delta 94 Heavy smack into some church vans and other automobiles. That's pretty much all she wrote. Whoa! Oh my god, Dynasty? Are you kidding me? Dynasty going off the north? Holy shit, fire. I gotta go over there and get that. Totally unprecedented, although I know it has happened before in the past. I have never borne witness to such an event. Free Chinese going off the north side, you've got to be out of your mind. But you're not. For Dynasty is putting on a spectacular show to make up for the runway 28 nonsense from earlier this morning. Thank you. Oh god, I have battery dead indicator. Christ, you better not die on me. To live long enough to at least see this very, very, very raritous takeoff from the north side by Dynasty 5254. Why would it do such a thing? My guess is weather. I'll show you all the cumulus boils down to the south of us here in a minute. That is if I have enough battery juice left. Oh, good. Oh, man. What a wonderful surprise. Thank you, Dynasty. Hell yeah. And so, as we pan out, we'll see the secondary boilers of the day are beginning. Those tops got to be way up there. But let's get back to charge. The skies to our west are beginning to darken again, and now it's time for the duty of wasp extermination. Just a mini assault, but as all assaults are, it is very important. It is for this reason that we will give these wasps a soundtrack to their death. Much like we did on the 4th of July last year, we will play music for them as they die. It just won't be patriotic music this time.
I'm ready, Slick, are you?
Oh, yeah.
Girl, I
Return to the Sky Meadow, as there is a storm on the south side of the field here causing some pretty sweet banking action on behalf of the departures perhaps. Southwestern New Livery banking hard away from this item, which is actually spitting a little rain at me. Damn, Southwestern, look at him go. Oh yeah, I think that thing's gonna pop into something pretty substantial. Takeoff line is also substantial. Still spitting rain. It's this guy right here spitting rain at me. Just spitting. It sucks. It's just every now and again, big fat lens splatter will pop you right in your lens. Hello! Takeoff line is looking interesting. Let's tune into the takeoff. And this is the producer. That right there. Waste this nasty looking thing right here. It's probably what's causing the jam up with the departures. I think they're shutting her down. They're shutting it down. That line is not going to get any shorter now. The rain is falling. Finally an arriver. We don't really have any departures going on. Everyone seems to be shutting it down. What do we have here? This rain continues to fall on my head. This looks like a Philadelphian ERJ-190. That's what I bet you. It's a cacti. Looks very cacti-like. Oh yeah. It's got cacti written all over it. Let's just keep cacti in the box. This thing to myself isn't really strengthening to the levels that I want it to. It's not reaching severe or anything. Oh, and around, and Philadelphians away. Interesting borderline between the blue and the storm, right? Look at that. Over here, blue. Over here, storm. Over here, takeoff line and blowing grass. Who's talking? Who's shutting down? Whoa! Hey, there's a 747. Holy shit. Is that Delta 73 heavy? Oh, I think it is. He's gonna have to go through the Sky Force. He's gonna have to travel long, long, and hard through that Sky Force. During the interim, we'll move up to the side of the street.
258.85 to 10,000. Clear to go. 275.
Cleared, huh? Wasn't that fantastic news? And other fantastic news, Delta 73, the king, the mighty lion, shall emerge from Sky Forest. Ugh, gross. Momentarily. Uh-oh, lens splatter, lens splatter. We don't want the king to see me with lens splatter. Let's dry your tears, wipe your eyes, before the king emerges. There he is! Perfect! We dried our eyes just in time. Nope, that's not... Lose the box integrity, jeez. Ah! Damn it! Good job, Delta 73 Heavy. You have done well for yourself on the... Ah! Wow, look at that. Those storms that are crossing the border from Alabama are up in the... What altitude is that? 48,000 at 50,000 feet when it goes yellow. And you can see this is yellow underneath all the lightning bolts. Hey, Continental United! Without a split centimeters, or does he? He does, he's got them. Anywho, the guys that are topping to the 50,000 feet mark are probably represented right there. Look how high up that hill. So we are in for some fun. We must conserve battery. Oh, here comes the Southwester in his new clothing. You know what I haven't seen in a long time? Southwester 738. Oh, I haven't. That's okay. It's okay, I haven't really been missing them. Do you have anything special about you other than your new attire? The bank is nice, I like that. And the heart on your belly. Yeah, you can tell these are the, they just get better every time I look back here at them. All right, who's clear for takeoff now? We're gonna lose the sunlight here in just a minute as those storm tops obscure it. Can I get some engine fog? Maybe not. It's a good look though, isn't it? Very good look. I believe 1775 at San Franciscan. I believe that's the flight I took myself. Oh, I saw a little bit there. Oh, good rotation. Nice. A private in the 767 outbound parade. Ah, what kind of banking will you do for me today? What in the hell? What is this? Oh, is this a hawker or something? That was unexpected, but a very pleasant surprise. I love this jetry. Especially the random ones that occur here on the south side. Goody, look how fast he jets out of here. Yeah, good job, hawker. Looking good, looking good. Everybody needs to get the hell out of town because I have a feeling 30 minutes is going to be next impossible. Up, 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 and away with you, Delta 24 Heavy. Get to Brussels quick. You can get a good aggressive bank, too. Aggressive bankage. Show me that bank, show me that bank, show me that, show me that, show me that bank. Goody. Oh, neato mosquito. Look at this guy off the north side banking to the south as well. Cool. He put on a little profile of double 767s here. Neato. Oh, man. Look at this thing. Now we're starting to see the leading edge of it here. Now, down here, it's the strongest. This has only produced one stroke or bolt of lightning, sweet cloud-to-ground lightning. Mad Dog Parade leaving the city, but beyond that, this is a much better spectacle. Look it, look it! Oh man, we got Lufty and a Delta 764 Munich Bounder sitting down there at the threshold of runway 27 right, wanting to get out of here, but this thing continues to look more majestic by the second. Look at that down there. I like that little raggedy thing. Not quite the producer that I would like you to be. I need you to grow. Become more productive with your lightning discharge. Oh, yeah! Oh, you all saw that, baby. Wow. Look at that thing. You can see it's almost like a shelf cloud forming here. And this little protrusion, which I like very much. It's like a goiter. Like the storm has a goiter. 130 heavy.
130 heavy. You'll be number 4 now.
Which means it'll be 2 hours. I'm already getting rained on. Oh, this is not a good time to be an underpowered A340-300, is it? No. You need all the power you can muster to get through that shit behind me, baby. Oh, good look. Lufty. Yeah, you still gotta wait a minute before you can rotate, right? Okay, here we go. Lufty's rotation. Oh my god, it's just black behind me. Oh yeah. Okay, Lumpy, how are you gonna handle it? My god almighty, it's glorious! Look at it! Oh yeah! Yes! Good, thank Lofty! My goodness! Wow! Oh man! Cool! Look at the vapor and everything! Wowzers! And here he comes! It will likely be the last departure for a minute. Oh wow. Are you a sky team? You might not be, I can't tell because the light is so Oh, it is sky team! Brilliant! Oh, sky team can make it through this mess if anybody can. Go patrol the skies, sky team. Uh-oh, fat raindrops just started falling. Wowzers! Oh, shit, yeah! Cool, sky team away! Oh, my God, look at that! Wow! Awesome! Oh, yeah, that's pretty fat rain now. My goodness. Everybody shut them down. Yeah, it does. Here we are, subterranean, is this monstrous area of what just looks like heavy-ass rain with the occasional cloud-to-ground fierce lightning bolt. It's just encroaching as quickly as it can now. Wow! Everything is shut down. I don't even think we have arrivals coming in now. It is a total stop. And I'm not getting any lens splatter from this perspective either. Subterranean south side. Current local time, 5:43 in the peak. And what a Saturday we have had. Sweet Jesus! Lens splatter suddenly becoming a huge issue. Oh my god! Oh my god! Yeah! Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! Better view. We have just more coming. Oh, Boise's. Just had a microburst alert. Of course, all the cool ATC transmissions occur as soon as I turn the camera off. But that storm that quickly passed over us is now, I guess, on the arrival end, as you can see by that little lightning flash. Oh, goody gumdrops. Well, round two is on its way here, which is going to prevent anything from occurring. Wow, look at that lightning strike, awesome. So, no movement, no action. There is actually action on the north side, so kiss the south side goodbye for the day, ladies and gentlemen. This is earning us a significant weather advisory, not severe thunderstorm.
Attention all departures,
oh, I see him. There's a 753 in from Orlando, making his way down on runway 28. Everyone's favorite runway today. Boo for that. Pressure spray? I know it's there, but I can't see it. No way, I think they're letting this American take off on runway 27 left. Holy shit, they are! Oh, this is gonna be sweet. We're gonna get some takeoff spray. Looks like it's actually a cacti in shiny McNot-so-shine attire. Beautiful, look at that. Oh, yeah. Oh, beautiful. I really don't see that very often. Cool. Oh, that is awesome. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Rotation from runway 27 left. Wow. Wow. Wowzers. What a day. This could be a very spectacular sight given the fact we're going to get a shit ton of takeoff spray and probably engine fog to boot and perhaps even vape. That sweet, sweet vape. All we need is this wall of doom to give birth a Delta 114 Heavy. And life will be grand. Oh, here comes the birthing. Oh my god, that looks awesome. Wow. Oh wow, he is light. Look at that. Damn, look at that. Sweet. Oh, beautiful. Yeah. Boy, I was not wrong about the vapor and the engine fog and the takeoff spray. Good job. Have fun in Barcelona. Oh, yeah! Cool. Oh, man. We couldn't have asked for a better grand finale. It's gorgeous. I love these reflections. I love all of the lights. I love the dark horizon to our east, and that 75 did not want to cooperate. Now he does. Now look at that engine fog. Wowzers! Reginald tries to steal the spotlight, but we will not allow that to happen. My god, even if you are just a 200, this is spectacular. Holy shit. Now, we're going to run out of battery in pretty short order here, but I have been here for pretty much like 10 hours today, and it has been one of the most marvelous days at Hartsfield Maynard Jackson Holbrook Maynard Atlanta International Airport in recent memory. I mean, god, think of all the stuff that we've seen today. Good god. And now look, just reflections. Awesome! Look at that engine fog. Wowzers. You can't even see the engine. It's just a little foggy hole. Foghole! Cool! Oh my god, it's awesome! Wow! Just doesn't stop, does it? Oh, sweet. 753, all the places that we don't know. But we know he is going there in style. He's left Atlanta like a champion. Like a champion of the giraffe. Good job, Mr. Man. And it's the sunny skies that are now predominant in our west. Oh, I think I see a classy. Oh, he is classy. Look at the takeoff lights. And wingletless. Brilliant. Oh, no, he's got winglets. I'm sorry, I retract that brilliant. But that was nice. It was nice. You get a nice, don't worry. A nice is good. It's a good. It's a good thing. It's like a B. Everyone likes a B. Unless you're an overachiever, one of those idiots. Like, they're gonna play. I hate myself. Oh, shiny. Oh, man. We are on battery deathbed. But we're gonna suck out enough juice to at least get you this. That's for sure. Shiny McShine. Helping us wrap out what has been one of the most spectacular days in recent memory. All of the things that we've seen, experienced, and how wet we got. You always know you've had a good day when you're soaking wet with sweat and precipitation from strong thunderstorms, yes? Okay, dead battery indicator. We're gonna have to go stick it back in the car, try to get a little bit more charge, because I got one last surprise for you. Not you, Shiny McShine, but you, the viewer. One last surprise. We'll call it a day. Oh, shiny! Oh, my look. Hawker. Shiny McShine. The Shiny McNot-So-Shine nose cone. Brilliant. And here's your surprise, ladies and gentlemen. Sir Francelot, the Not-So-Mighty Frog, 681 to Petty, has chosen the north side for departure this evening. Well, that doesn't surprise me, considering the jam up on the south side. Wow, did you see that rudder kick? Cool. All right, let's get this party started so we can end it. Official grand finale. There could not be a better one. Whoa. Oh God, dead battery indicator causes me a lot of stress, please. Live on just for this. Oh my God, please. Stay alive long enough to capture the not-so-mighty frog. Oh. Oh man, look at that. Look at that. Oh, beautiful. What a day. What a day. Holy shit. Saturday, June the 27th, a day that will live in our memories forever as one in which cool things happened constantly throughout the day. Wowzers! We had just enough battery power to pull it off, didn't we? Yeah!